And we're back to learning Inkscape, and this time I'm going to show you how to create an abstract line design. We can use this tool right here, the draw freehand lines. P is the short key for that, and we need the create spiral path function. This moving is important. Let me go down to a low value, let's say 5, and I drag this. It's a freehand draw, and it keeps or preserves lots of the wobbly lines that I've drawn. If you go higher, they will be smoothened out. So the higher you go, the better your lines will look. But be careful, at a certain point, let me go higher to 50. It smoothens it out so far that you've got a straight line right here. So you need to find some kind of sweet spot. I guess 25 is fine here. Make sure that shape is none and it should work for you. Let me select it all, I get rid of it, and I draw these lines. One by one, I'll make sure that I've got overlaps. Let me add one more. All right, select it all with the cursor tool, and then go to extensions, generate from path, and interpolation. The exponent should be 0.0. Check the live preview. And if you see a warning message, just click on OK. It should still render it. The interpolation method, it makes a difference. So if we set that to 2, we have a slightly different result. Just test both and pick the one that you like better. Interpolation steps, they define how many of these lines are created. Let me play around a little bit with it. Maybe I'll stay with the interpolation method too. It looks better. Let me try 20 for the steps. 30 look better. When you've got what you want, just apply it and then close your menu. Select it all, then go to object and ungroup. And we've got all of these lines as individual elements that we can select and drag down here. If you've got lines that are a little bit more intense, for example down here, it's because there are lines overlapping each other. You can see that if I zoom in and drag them down. The best way to deal with that is to just select them and delete them. So let me do that here at the bottom. And here at the top. And if I delete them, the intensity gets lower and lower. And I can do that at the bottom as well. Alright, that looks fine. You can select it all and give it a different color. But keep in mind, you want to set the stroke color, so not the fill. So click on the X to get rid of the fill and then hold shift and click on your swatches to have the stroke color adjusted. Let me pick some bluish color here. If you want to deal with the edges, you can just create a rectangle, set it to a certain size. Let me get rid of the stroke here, I'll shift click on the X and I give it a fill. And select it all. Let me group the lines in the background so that we can see that properly. I do that pressing Ctrl G, but prior I've deselected the rectangle. Now I'll select it all, right click and set clip. And this is how you can cut the edges if you want to. But be careful at the top and bottom to not cut the lines. So let me press Ctrl Z and I resize the rectangle. Select it again once more, right click, set clip. And this is how you can create this abstract line design in Inkscape. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next time.